The House sitting today turned rowdy after a video in which MP Francis Zakye was heard bad-mouthing Rakai District Woman MP Juliet Kinyamatama Subi in her constituency surfaced. It was brought to the attention of the parliament by Kinyamatama herself, who rose on the point of procedure. Kinyamatama tabled the video clip before parliament and demanded that the video be played to parliament, a proposal that faced resistance from the opposition.
Words used against me are so demeaning that I can't even mention in my mouth.
It then ascended into a tug of war on the floor of the house on whether the video clip be played or not until the matter was put to vote and the ayes had it.
I want the members of parliament to see what exactly happened. I have been keeping my cool, but I want this house to see what exactly happened, Right Honourable Speaker. We cannot cover evil. We cannot cover men that don't respect women. I cannot be called what he called me.
Yeah.
The environment on the floor heated up and the Deputy Speaker suspended the sitting for 10 minutes, which escalated into 50 minutes. During this time, Taiba convened a closed-door meeting with the complainant and the leadership of both the opposition and the government. The House later reconvened and the video was played on the screens erected in the chambers after another set of resistance from the opposition, which wanted a statement from the government apologizing on the recent wanton arrests of the opposition leaders and supporters to come first.
President Thomas and the Okonkwo know. The eyes have it, play the video. I want to subject my decision to your vote.
The Speaker referred the matter to the Rules Committee of Parliament to investigate it and bring a report to Parliament in 45 days.
As per Rule 175 of our Rules of Procedure, Chair and your team, you have up to 45 days to respond to this matter. I need the item now for the Minister of Internal Affairs.
Otherwise, I fear that to turn this Parliament, I go and quarrel with Sech Kubo, he comes here, it becomes Parliament. The Honourable,
so much kindly.
So the procedural issue I'm raising, Mr. Speaker, is whether our rules that require decorum in this Parliament can allow screening of words a member has said cannot be uttered.
As drama unfolded on the floor, the opposition, which was returning to the House after 2 days' boycott, looked puzzled in an ambush as the statement from the government was not forthcoming.
When members demand for a statement of any nature, and it takes that long, it delays inordinately, and the member reminds the House of that inordinate delay, and instead it impeaches another matter, Honourable Speaker, that speaks to ill will on the part of government. And as the opposition, we abhor ill will. We are patient over so many matters. But when we demand for particular situations to be clarified and they are construed as favors, Honourable Speaker, 2 weeks ago, you promised that you would compel government to respond so many unanswered questions on the floor. This is week 3. There's no response.
As the Minister of State for Internal Affairs started reading the opposition statement, then another set of drama cropped up by Kinyamatama, who wanted to go physical with the Mitiana municipality legislator, which forced the presiding officer to adjourn the sitting prematurely to Tuesday next week. Opposition legislators felt cheated and accused NRM for staging drama to deny them a chance of receiving a statement from the government over the recent attack on opposition leaders.
Honourable colleagues, House adjourned to Tuesday at 2 p.m.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.